Hi, welcome to the final panel discussion of the MOOC Co-Creating Sustainable Cities. We have a panel for you on the table with Maarten, Ilse, my name is Gert, Walter, Sanneke and Jotte. And what we will do is to discuss a number of topics that have been recurrent themes in the MOOC. In this MOOC, we discussed with you different forms of co-creation that we found in the field of sustainability transitions. And we worked on both an inter- and transdisciplinary basis. So you have seen many different kind of people, both experts and lay people, water engineers, air quality specialists, people that are into spatial design, food growers, NGOs, CBOs, people from companies, and of course, citizens. Citizens, they have a very important role and emphasis in our MOOC. We ourselves have been surprised by the large number of different forms of co-creation that we found around the world. It seems like everyone is talking about it. Everyone is doing co-creation. Co-creation is hot. Co-creation is also, it seems, a very positive thing. It produces, it contributes to innovation and to more sustainable cities. Well, the questions that we are dealing on this table here is, are there some lessons that we can learn from what we have seen in this book? So can we reduce the large number of co-creation forms and dynamics to a few more basic forms or categories? Are there some recurrent themes and topics that must be discussed when you talk about co-creation? Think, for example, about data, data generation. And then as a third major issue, we wonder whether co-creation is only a positive phenomenon that should be elaborated and promoted, or that there are also some kind of negative or shadow sides to co-creation. So these are the topics that we have for you today. So the first distinction that we are going to discuss is the one between co-creation of city politics on the one hand and co-creation of social technical systems on the other. So this is a distinction that was introduced at the beginning of the course because we have a very strong emphasis in the MOOC on sustainability transitions in cities, and sustainability in cities is related to kind of social technical systems like the energy and the water and the waste management system that kind of determines how sustainable a city is. Of course, these systems are influenced by city politics, but if you talk about co-creation, we thought it would be relevant to make this initial distinction. And I'm curious to hear if the panel, if they agree with that. So, Sanneke, can you just comment on how useful you think it is to make this distinction between social technical systems that are being co-created by citizens and the formal political system of the city that is being co-created?
Yes, well, as an analytical distinction, I think it can be useful to make a distinction between the city politics and the social technical systems, because we've seen in the course that there are different forms of co-creation, and co-creating city politics has different forms than co-creating socio-technical systems. And so we've seen examples such as citizens buying their own solar panels to generate their own electricity, citizens co-creating water systems in Kampala, for example. So these are clearly examples where citizens engage in co-creating water or energy or waste systems.
Yeah. I think indeed it could be useful to make the distinction. On the other hand, there it's also a lot of times that there's these forms can be similar indeed. You can invite people to discuss things, but you can also do that about energy. And therefore these forms can happen over both politics and social technical systems. And maybe there's even topics that are almost in between them that are hard to distinguish between the two. So it's more like a continuum almost of different forms.
Yeah, I can see what you mean. But isn't it an issue whether citizens themselves define it as a kind of politics or as something doing something different? So sometimes people can be co-creating technical systems without thinking about city politics. And I think that's then it's helpful not to talk to them about, oh, you are doing politics, because they say, no, I'm just handling waste. I'm just repairing the water system.
But so indeed, that should be good. Okay, that's their idea, but in the end, of course, indirectly, they could still influence the politics.
Of course, a political scientist would kind of not take no for an answer there. I agree. So talking about these social technical systems, Maarten, is air quality, is that also a social technical system in your opinion?
Yeah, well, not directly, of course, but of course, air quality is associated with a lot of social technical systems, like cooking or transportation systems, and there, of course, a distinction between politics and the social technical systems is a bit difficult, because the government is responsible for instance, for infrastructure for transport,
yeah.
And people are themselves responsible for cooking in their house, so there. The distinction between politics on the one hand and social technical systems on the other hand is a bit hard to make.
Yeah, I can see what you mean.
But at the same time, I think you see, for example, in Beijing, that air quality is a very political issue. There's restricted, limited space for citizens to address the topic of air quality, and also that they petition the state to address air quality issues. So there, I think you see that the citizens, via political means, they want the government to make a change in the social technical system. So then again, you see maybe a little bit a distinction. But that there's politics involved about those socio-technical systems.
Exactly. And the way to solve the air quality problem involves social-technical systems like transportation systems, public transport, etc. So there is always this interaction. Yeah.
So Chinese citizens are on the one hand car drivers, so they are kind of co-creating a technical system like mobility system, which is kind of not very good for air quality. And at the other hand, they are also demanding their government to change air quality politics, to be more severe, more strict in fighting the haze. Yeah. So they are both in terms of social technical system co-creation and in terms of politics co-creation, they have this kind of role.
Yeah, so although you can split them up, you see they're always linked.
That's
actually.
It,
yeah.
Because it's the same kind of Chinese citizens in the end. Mm-hmm. So we agree more or less that it is a helpful analytical distinction, but in reality we always have kind of mixtures of both. Yeah, okay.